Welcome. This tutorial will help you understand the way OWL is organized. We're looking at OWL Tester right now. This is the view your test taker would experience. So that's the first definition. A test is the top level. It is the name given for any activity you want to deliver using OWL. A test is required. Even if you want to use the software to ask one or two questions, they must be placed on a test to be delivered online through OWL. All OWL tests are composed of certain main elements. They are organized here on the tabs at the top of Tester. Let's take a look at each of these elements. The first page that may be displayed is a system check. Its purpose is to confirm that the examinee's speakers and microphone are in proper working order. You don't need to worry about creating this. OWL does it for you based on the content of the test that you built. Next is the directions tab. If you decide to include some directions or a welcome page for your test takers, it will appear here. The next element we have is the section. By default, every OWL test must have at least one section. Questions are not put straight onto the test. They are contained within a section. Think of an OWL section as a container for grouping like items. OWL allows you to set properties such as timers or randomization for each of your sections independently. OWL sections are composed of items. Each one of these tabs at the bottom of the section represents an OWL item. Every section must contain at least one item. This is a section header. Text, images, audio files that you place here are displayed at the top of every item within that section. Let me show you a couple ways to organize your sections. Here is an example where information is placed in the front of the section using a directions item. In this section, a passage of text is placed at the top of the header to evaluate reading comprehension. You can display all your items on one page if that is preferable. Finally, each test must have a finished test tab. This lets the student know that testing is complete and allows them to submit their test. The feedback can be dynamic, meaning what the test taker sees here is based on their performance, or static, every test taker sees the same thing. OWL will do some of this for you based on your test settings. You can use the OWL default messages or customize this tab. Now that you've been introduced to the OWL structure, I will show you where you edit these components in the Test Builder. The OWL Test Builder is what you will use to create your online content. So now on the left side of the screen is the OWL test as the test taker would see it, and on the right I have opened the Test Builder. First of all, this entire area below the main controls represents the test. The first element you can edit is the Directions tab. The controls for this are located here in what we call the test header. If I click on this hyperlink, you will see the text that I created for my directions tab. Next, we have the sections. Each section is included in its own tan area of the test builder. Look at the hyperlink here at the top of the section. It is the text I placed in my section's header, and the highlighted media controls indicate that I have an audio file attached. Within the section, each of the items is shown in a blue area. Finally, the Finish Test tab. To customize this message, use the Overall Test Settings control located here. For this sample, I have created a customized static feedback message, which I enter in this box. Thank you for your time and for choosing OWL testing software.